Greetings, Eric Bakker, naturopath from New Zealand. Thank you for coming back. When we talk about Blastocystis, I've just looked at several studies just now regarding Blastocystis. It's becoming so prevalent now that they believe that over 1 billion people worldwide are going to be colonized with this very soon. Many people had it, have got it now. When I first started practice years ago, the odd person would have an intestinal parasite. And the thing is, we didn't really hear that much about it. There was no Google, there was no internet. People didn't travel as frequently as they do today. Aeroplane travels become very cheap. When I was a young guy, aeroplane travel was very, very expensive. Fuel costs were much greater, you know, in comparison with other modes of travel. It was cheaper to sail, in fact, on a boat, on a large ship, than it was to fly in a jetliner. But now it's so cheap to fly. People are moving around the globe, you know, like ants, they're going everywhere. People are coming from countries to your country and you're going to their country. So we're basically creating a parasite exchange program when you think about it. We're giving bugs to other people, they're giving bugs to us, we're sort of swapping bugs around. And dying amoeba now, and Blastocystis and other parasites like that are becoming quite endemic. So many people have them now. Many doctors I've spoken to, and in fact one gastroenterologist, believe now that we should just accept these parasites as a normal part of the bowel flora, because they believe that most people are asymptomatic or don't really have symptoms when they find these parasites in their gut. But I beg to differ very much so on this point. I've looked at thousands of stool tests, and I can tell you now without a shadow of a doubt, when I see Blastocystis in every single sample of a patient, you know, when we do a 3-day collection and we see many blasto in each sample, the patient has IBS symptoms, as clear as it's daylight. Is it daylight today? Yep, it's daylight today. Well, as clear as it's daylight out there, that's what I'm seeing. So I don't know where these scientists are coming from, but the more blasto I see in a patient's stool, the higher the chance that patient has of an IBS, an irritable bowel-like syndrome. It doesn't belong. Parasites do not like this belong in such high counts in someone's digestive system. And the creepy thing is there are variants of blasto as well. One variant I just looked at, I think it's called C7P or CP7 or something. It's a slight change on the normal blasto. This blasto actually kills beneficial bacteria and it gangs up on them and it's aided by bifidobacteria. So bifidobacteria can actually aid blasto in some cases. E. coli, Blastocystis and bifido get together like three buddies and they can create a lot of destruction. So these things don't by default belong in our gut, especially at high count. So what do you do when you've got blasto? Check out my Blastocystis videos. The Candida Remove works very well at cleaning up the gut and reducing the blastocystic load. But please do have a look at my videos I've completed on Blastocystis because there's a few on this channel. There aren't that many on YouTube, but I've created a few of them so you can understand a bit more about this single-celled, you know, this protozoan, this organism that we get in our gut. We commonly get it from land animals, you know, from cows, sheep, dogs, cats, things like that. It can be transmitted in families. Many healthy people never ever get blasto, and many healthy other people can get blasto. But check out the videos. It'll explain a bit about it so you can understand what it is. But does it belong in the normal gut flora? My opinion, no, it doesn't belong there, and it shouldn't be there. It should be cleaned up. And when you've got a strong presence of beneficial counts, generally they will take care of these kind of things, and you'll get on top of these parasite infections. Thanks for the question.